Do you want to know a really powerful method of magic that will look really pretty, but be so powerful and nobody knows it? It's sigil magic. This week's magic lesson, we are talking about sigil magic. What's a sigil, you say? A sigil is a symbol. Actually, this pentacle is a sigil for paganism, being a witch. A heart is a sigil or symbol of love, a dollar sign for money. But in magic, especially in chaos magic, and now we've just all adopted it, there's something called a sigil that we draw. And what that is putting intent into magical words, changing the words into something where you can't see the words, empowering it magically, and then you've got something only you have, and you create that. It will amp everything up tenfold. Let me show you a sigil right now. This sigil is a magical sigil. There's about 10 words in that magical sigil. It's part of a group that I work with, but it's just turned into a beautiful art piece. You could take words. So let's make, and believe me, Fortune 500 companies do this. They have this beautiful little logo. And what it really says on the inside is buy my product. Probably, or just I'm doing magic and love and money and health and whatever you're trying to do. So let me give you a simple version of a spare sigil. There's a guy called Austin Osmond Spare, who back in the day, I think it's in the 40s or 50s, he was like kind of one of the fathers of chaos magic. He invented a spare sigil. So what that is, say you have something that you want to get. Maybe you want to improve your health or your something like that. So write down the words that you really want. Say healthy, strong, maybe happy. Maybe you just in your life, you want more health and strength and happiness. So write down healthy, strength, happy. Now we don't need, you're going to squish them all together. Now, most times you get rid of the vowels. You don't get rid of the A's, get rid of everything, the vowels. So now you have a bunch of H, P, P, Y, H, and you, oh, wait, you have a second H. You get rid of all the double letters. So if you already have an H, you get rid of the first H. I should have drawn this out, but I'll show you later. So like if the Patty, P-A-T-T-I, I'd lose the A and I'd lose the I and I end one T. All of a sudden, P-T becomes my sigil for Patty. So on happy, healthy, strong, you've gotten rid of the vowels. You've gotten rid of any doubles in any letter. So there's only one H, there's only one T, there's only one L. So you've got this thing. And part of the magic is you sitting there drawing and creating a little magical sigil or symbol with it. You guys know I work with sigils a lot, like with runes, like the Helm of Awe sigil is a sigil. They don't all have to be English words, but say you have this beautiful thing and you've turned it into something that looks like stick people or looks like an art piece or looks like a flower. A really good thing to see an example is Google spare sigil and then just do images and you'll go, oh, I've got it. So now you've got your little magical thing and this says beauty, health, whatever you want it to say. Now you have to charge it. Remember, magic is intent. So whether you're seeing yourself having it, whether you want to do a little ma chant, health here, health now, health, it is mine. Beauty here, beauty now, strength, you are fine. Ah, drum, dance around, set it up to the, breathe into it. Now you have this beautiful charged sigil that says all those words. People can't even read all those words. You could stick it on candles. You could carve it on wax candles. You could put it on a Sharpie on the back of a candle. You could fold it up and put it in your wallet. You could put it in your magical oven box to keep. You can burn it and send it to the heavens. But sigil magic in itself is focused intent where you are creating the spirit of the thing that you are creating. That symbol, focused intent of beauty, health, strength, whatever that is, you've created this little magical thing out of it. Here's a little bit of a sigil of my school right there. It's a sigil of my school. It's a bit of a symbol, but you put the magic into it and carry it in your pocket. Put it, I have sigils under my welcome mat for protect my home. Helm of Awe is one of them. You step it under, it protects it from ghosts and burglars, everything in the middle. So try some sigil magic. Make up your own if you don't want. There's many ways to do it, but it's about the intent, seeing the word, seeing the focus, breathing into it, and then you have your own magical logo. That's sigil magic. You are the magic. Sometimes you just have to draw it out yourself.